Good evening everyone. In this video we are going to discuss some of the molding process like extrusion molding process as well as the thermoforming and reinforcing. So in the reinforcing it have two types. One is the hand lathe method, another one is the filament winding method. So here first we are going to discuss the extrusion molding process. So extrusion molding process, it is going to manufacture the component continuously. So for that we have to provide some suitable die so that it keep on continuously producing the components over here. With help of this machine, you can manufacture like rods, sheets, as well as straps and hoses, tubes, filament and films. So these are all the things you can going to create over with the help of this extrusion molding process. And also one more point, this is the cheapest one. So that it may be used for to manufacture the plastic components. Okay, so this molten plastic under suitable condition, it is forced to through the die orifice which imparts the desired profile on the extra die. Okay, so then comes into the this machine, the compound plastic materials is fed through the hopper as either powder or granules over here. So this is the upper. So here only the plastic or granules will be posted over here. Plastic or granules that will be put over here. Then this powder or granules into a cylinder having the provision for electrical heating. So the heaters they will be provided over here. So with help of that heating, the material gets softened over here so that hot plastic charge is further worked through the cylinder by helically provided revolving screw. So already we people know that this is the helically revolving screw. Then the temperature of the plastic material rises on and it creates the frictional heat on the frictional heat to be produced on the compression of charge between the rotating screw and the cylinder surface. So during this journey from the hopper to the die, the plastic material passes through the via the threads. So that zone is called it as the feed zone and as well as the compression zone and metering zone. So it will be shown in this figure over here, feed section, compression section and marketing section. So before it will be entering the die, it will be called it as these names. Okay, so in this, each zone contribute in its own way to the overall extrusion process. So the feed zone for instance, it receives a charge from the hopper and sends it over to the compression zone. So no heating takes place in the feed zone. The in the compression zone, the powder charge melts due to the heat conducted from the heating element like a heater and the compressed by working the screw. So the pasty molten plastic material is then sent to the melting section. Okay, so in the melting section, that is the metering section. So in the metering section, it acquires the constant flow rate that it will be imparted by the helical flight of the screw over here. Then the pressure built up the section, it will be enables the polymer to melt and to enter the die and emerge the it is of with the desired profile due to the highly viscous nature in the some of the polymers. However, one more region is called it as working zone. It may also be required over here. Okay, so in the polymer, it could be subjected to the high shearing forces with the effective mixture over here. Then the extruded material of the required profile emerging from the die, it will be quite hot. Normally the temperature it may be varies from 100 to 300 degrees centigrade over here, and it has to be cooled rapidly, avoid the D shaping. It will be rapidly cooling, avoid by the D shaping. So the extra already we people know that about the D shaping. So the extra dead is accordingly carried over a conveyor belt through the tube containing cold water. So during this process, the material dissipates the heat or to the water and gets set. So cold air blast and cold water spray can also used to cooling the product and formed and cut the desired length or wound on the rolls. Okay, so this is the extrusion molding process over here. Okay, so in this process they may be used some of the coating wires as well as the PVC. okay, so this will be the extrusion molding process. Next we are going to discuss the thermoforming. So the thermoforming is the highly fabricating three dimensional device from the plastic sheet. So in some large products such submarines and hulls are made the this ABS sheet by the thermoforming technique. So here the thermoforming this one there will be provided over here. Okay, so this technique it can be explained like this. The thermoplastic sheet is heated to its softening and softening temperature, and warm flexible sheet is then pressed into the female off of a matched metal die, duly assisted by the male off. Okay, so now the sheet assumes that required shape of the mold. On cooling, the shape of the articles become the rigid and can remove from the mold over here. Just you are going to keep the material, then you can press it, then the required shape you are going to get. So after cooling, the component you can remove from the work surface area. Okay, so in this method, the hot plastic sheet is sucked into the cavity of the female mold under the influence of vacuum, give the desired shape. So this method is also called as vacuum forming method. Okay, this is about the thermoforming. Then comes into the next thing is the reinforcing. So here reinforcing is the plastic matrix with the high strength fiber material. It results in the formation of the what are called the fiber reinforced plastic. So the FRP material it will be used. FRP has outstanding properties such as high strength to weight ratio and excellent corrosion resistance and easy to fabricate. Okay, so there are several methods to production the reinforced plastic. So three of the most commonly used techniques are the hand layup method, filament winding method, and another one is the spray up technique. So first here we are going to discuss about the hand layup method. So in the hand layup method, they also it is called it as open mold method. So in the open mold method, the roller is available, and in this one the polymer resin reinforcement and release gate as the, so this is the roller. Okay, so then this is the resin. So in the hand layup method, so we can get some different thickness, up to that we can lay up the roller over in the components. So mainly in this hand layup method, probably it is the simplest method and also oldest one. It producing the reinforced plastic articles. The quality of the end product depends on the large extent of the skill of the operator. So the whole process it consists of the follow the steps. So that is the mold. First initially it will be thin coating the agent such as polyvinyl alcohol and silicon oil they may used over here. The mold then coated with a resin matrix, pre-cut glass cloth or mat, then laid onto the resin layer. Okay, so now the once the first layer is formed, then above that the second layer is going to form over here in the resin coating, so given over the glass cloth. So rollers are used to press the glass cloth on the resin uniformly and also remove the entrapped air bubbles. Okay, so the resins also it will be able to move away the bubbles from the this particular layer process. Okay, so and alternate layers of the resin glass cloth are laid on the similar sequence until the required thickness should be built up. So we can create the some different types of thickness over in this one. So wherever we decide the thickness is enough, so there we are going to stop the laying up process over here. So this whole setup is then cooled either at ambient or elevated temperature over here. So after the curing is complete, the reinforced plastic material thus formed and removed from the mold and subjected to the trimming and finishing. That means after taking the component, we are going to do the some patchwork like trimming and finishing process. So mainly the finishing process is required for this hand layer process. Okay, so then it may be used for to manufacturing like ducts as well as the building components and auto body parts as well as bottles. So these are all the components that will be manufactured with the help of this technique. This is about the hand layer technique. So the next one we are going to discuss the filament winding technique. So mainly to creating the reinforced plastic, this is the method widely used over there. So it will be used as a some high pressure cylinders and storage tank and rocket motor bodies. So to creating this will be used, and in this process the continuous length of the strand and roving and woven tape they may used over here. So this via this way the fiber is passed through the bath and resin to purity. So as the strand comes out of the excess resin is squeezed out, the resin is dipped filament or strand is then wound over a mandrel of the required shape and subsequently cured the under the influence of heat over here. So the through roller, so here we can say it as a nip roller. So here it reaches the another roller, the filament is actually pulled and stretched by the one more roller. So under the, so there are several rollers are fixed over here. So once so it will be passing over those rollers, it may be tension is imparted by the into the pin. So stretching takes place at the certain zone, and finally the filament is connected from the rotating mandrel. Okay, so during this drawing process the filament diameter gets reduced as it is stretched under tension or okay. So this is about the filament winding technique. So with that the molding process get over. Thank you.